I'm Weldon Dodd, Senior Vice President of Global Solutions here at Kandji. I'm speaking to you today from our London office, and I'm excited to introduce you to a new feature that we're calling assignment maps. Assignment maps represent a whole new way to manage and secure your fleet of Apple devices. Traditionally, device management software required IT teams to assign configurations to devices using complex combinations of rules. While this was meant to allow for infinite granularity, it also created its own set of challenges. Some rules might conflict with each other, troubleshooting became difficult. It was hard to know why one device got the right set of configurations and another did not. Ultimately, admins got tied down trying to manage it all. We wanted something better. Kandji was built around the concept of blueprints. Blueprints provide a straightforward way to achieve the desired state for your Apple fleet. A blueprint is a collection of library items, profiles, settings, scripts, security controls, and apps. Any device that's added to that blueprint gets all those library items. It's a direct, straightforward, point-and-click way to configure devices at scale. Kandji blueprints let you definitively determine how your Apple devices will be configured. There's no ambiguity about the configuration it will get. Blueprints also give you excellent visibility into those configurations. If you look at a blueprint in the Kandji web app, you can immediately see which library items will be enforced on any device assigned to it. It's essentially a manifest. If you're in the engineering blueprint or the sales blueprint, here are all the settings, scripts, and apps you're going to get. Kandji blueprints make device management and security incredibly clear for everyone. As time went on, we did wonder, could we take the simplicity and clarity of blueprints and add more flexibility, more granular targeting, even more automation, which is what you need when you're scoping at scale? And could we do that without creating a tangled mess? That's why we are introducing assignment maps. It's a radically new and incredibly powerful way to configure Apple devices in Kandji. Here to tell you more about how that works is Kandji Staff Product Manager, Mike Boylan.
Thanks, Weldon, and hello, everyone. I'm Mike, and I'm here in Kandji's San Francisco office. We know assignment maps are going to have a revolutionary impact on how our customers organize and manage their fleets. And they're unlike any other approach out there today. We love blueprints at Kandji. And at the end of the day, an assignment map is a blueprint. In the Kandji web app, assignment maps live side by side with classic blueprints. Like classic blueprints, assignment maps contain library items, which contain the configurations that get applied to devices. But they determine which ones get applied in a very different way. Assignment maps are made up of conditional blocks placed on an infinite canvas that contain one or more assignment nodes. Each of these nodes is a collection of settings and configurations that are to be assigned to a group of devices. Conditional statements are used to decide whether or not the items in a node are actually assigned. With assignment maps, we had a number of goals in mind to build a world-class experience for managing devices. First, we wanted to maintain the exclusionary nature of classic blueprints. A device can belong to just one map at a time, and only library items included on the map can be installed. Second, we wanted to make library items more reusable, so a given item can be used multiple times in a single map, even with different rules applied. Third, we wanted to allow rules to be nestable, to allow for additional granularity and specificity in assignments. Fourth, we wanted to make testing and troubleshooting way easier for admins, so there's never a question as to why or how a device got a particular configuration. And finally, perhaps the most important consideration, to make sure that conflicting settings are not assigned to a device, while at the same time not limiting the shape or form of a map in any way, still allowing for ultimate flexibility. Assignment maps have an inherent priority system to resolve any conflicting settings before they get applied to any devices. Let me show you how this all works by making a real assignment map. First, I'll get started at the Blueprints page in the Kandji web app. Here, you see a new section for assignment maps. I click here to create my first one. Like classic blueprints, you have a choice of creating a map from scratch or creating it based on a template. In this example, I'm going to start from scratch and give it a name of AccuHive Main Map. When the map appears, I'm going to click Edit Assignments and notice that I have all of my library items for my entire Kandji tenant over here on the left in the library item bank. I can filter that list of library items to make it easier to add them to the map, and I can sort them as well. Notice that this first node says all devices. Every map starts with this node and it can't be removed. As the name implies, library items you add to this node will install on all devices as long as they're appropriate. Library items you set to install on iPad, for example, will install on all iPads, and those set for Mac will install on all Mac computers, and so on. For our example, let's add a restrictions profile, a login window profile, Google Chrome, Microsoft Office, Slack, and Zoom to all devices. And if that's all I wanted to configure for this map, I could press save. It's that easy. But now, let me add a new conditional block and define a rule. I'll pick department is one of sales or marketing. I can now drop some more library items, like box and CleanShot, into this new node. Those library items will be installed on devices that are assigned to users in those departments, which Kandji knows based on our example tenant's user directory integration with Okta. Let me make one more edit. I'm going to add an else if condition for if the department is R&D, which in our example includes developers, designers, and product managers. For this group, I'm going to install Figma, Python, and Sublime. Now, let me save this. And that's it. I've made my first map, with some settings and apps going to all devices, and some apps going to just sales, marketing, or R&D. With this amount of flexibility, it's entirely possible that you could configure your entire fleet using just one assignment map, or at least just a very small number of them. And now, to showcase even more power of assignment maps, here's Senior Product Designer Rachel Rochin.
Thanks, Mike. As you've seen, assignment maps are highly visual. That's not just about having a pretty interface. Maps make it easier to see the relationships between groups of devices and to see which settings and configurations are being applied to them. We weren't satisfied with the approach that some other solutions take, which applies settings directly to groups. That can make it difficult to see which settings a given device should get because it may belong to many overlapping groups. Assignment maps also let you assign settings to groups. However, they introduce an extra layer of if-else logic, which organizes and prioritizes those groups. This lets you better visualize and manage relationships between groups while also avoiding conflicts. Let's talk about several of the intuitive ways assignment maps resolve conflicts between library items. First, as Mike mentioned, a device can only be assigned to one map at a time. It will receive only the library items on the map it's assigned to. Then, if a library item in the same map conflicts with another, we simply apply the library item that appears last in the map's evaluation, or furthest to the right, to the device. So, if you have a setting in the All Devices node at the beginning of the map, and another that conflicts with it further down in the map, we'll apply just that last one. This means you can get increasingly granular in your scoping, and not worry about whether a setting for a more specific group conflicts with a setting for a broader group that you've already specified. Assignment maps also make it incredibly easy to troubleshoot. That is, to see why certain settings were or were not applied to a device. With our device lookup feature, you can see the path that any device took through the map in order to receive its assignments. Let's take a look at how all this works in practice. Let's start by creating a new group, engineers, as a subgroup of the R&D group. We want these engineers to get all the apps the R&D group does, but also some apps that are just for them. To do that, I'll click this plus button here on the R&D node to create a new conditional block. I'll add rules in the first if statement to target devices whose users are in engineering. I'll then add library items that will be assigned just to them, such as AWS VPN client and Postman. As devices are evaluated, when they match the R&D rule, they will receive the R&D apps. Then, if they're in engineering, they will receive the engineering apps. If they aren't in engineering, they will not receive any extra library items here and will simply move on through the rest of the map. Now, when I view the map, I can easily see all the apps that go to the entire R&D group and those that go just to engineers. I can add or remove apps to these groups as needed. For example, let's say I need to give a new app to the engineering team. I'll just select it here and drag it into that same node. Now let's look at conflicts. As Mike mentioned, the map will avoid any conflict on a device through inherent priority. Let's see how this works by adding multiple managed OS library items to our map. First, we'll create a conditional block that will assign different managed OS library items depending on which OS the device is currently running. So, if macOS version is greater than or equal to 14, assign Sonoma, which will continuously enforce minor version updates for users who are already on macOS Sonoma. Else, for everyone else, assign Ventura, which will continuously enforce minor version updates for our users on Ventura. Even though there are multiple managed OS library items on this map, it's impossible for a device to be assigned more than one. That's because of the first match nature of the if-else logic. First, the map will check to see whether devices have an OS greater than 14. If they do, they'll receive the Sonoma library item. Otherwise, they'll get Ventura. So let's say I want to test the latest minor Sonoma version with a pilot group. You'll notice I've added a few blocks later in my map for the Sonoma pilot group. Now I'll assign my managed OS library item configured with the latest minor Sonoma version to this pilot group. Notice the icon that appears. This lets me know that there's another managed OS library item in the map, and that any devices that qualify for more than one of them will get the one that was assigned last, which means furthest to the right in the map. Following that logic, my pilot group here will get the Sonoma library item assigned here. As a best practice, we recommend building maps from more general categories on the left to more specific ones on the right. Okay, we've got this map up and running. Now let's say I want to see all of the library items that are going to a particular device. Maybe I want to confirm that a device in my pilot group is getting the right OS. I can use the device lookup feature to find my device. Once it's selected, I can see the path that this particular device took through the map's logic, as well as all of the library items it qualified for. I can hover over nodes it did not qualify for to see which rules were not met. We can also see here that the first OS this device was assigned is grayed out, in favor of the version of Sonoma OS that was assigned further to the right, which is highlighted. This lets me know that my pilot Sonoma library item was correctly assigned to this device in my pilot group. And if I go to the device record, I can see there's a convenient link right here next to the devices listed blueprint. I can click that to go directly into my lookup view we just saw and troubleshoot any assignments. So there you have it. We're really excited about assignment maps, and we think Kandji customers will be too. Back to you, Weldon.
Thanks, Rachel. I agree. I think assignment maps are one of the most exciting new capabilities we've introduced to Kandji, and it'll be great to see what our customers do with them. Assignment maps are an important part of allowing for additional flexibility in Kandji to meet the needs of all customers, from large enterprise to small and medium business. But we aren't done. We're already at work on some really useful additions beyond assignment maps. We're adding the ability to dynamically assign a device to a specific assignment map or a classic blueprint when it enrolls in Kandji based on the conditions you specify. That functionality, which we're calling blueprint routing, is coming in the near future and will make device enrollment even more seamless and automated. We're also looking at new ways to group devices in Kandji beyond the user and device attributes that are available today. This will let you get even more targeted with your mapping. These two additions are going to unlock even more power from assignment maps. So stay tuned. there's plenty more to come. We think that assignment maps are just one more reason that Kandji is and will continue to be the most powerful way to manage fleets of Apple devices now and into the future. Thanks for joining us today. If you have any questions about assignment maps or Kandji, contact your Kandji customer success representative or visit kandji.io.